some more. So we're standing up on the mat this morning, and given that there are some more dynamic movements, just checking in with your body and seeing if it's okay for you to do those movements. So we'll begin with this twisting. So if you ever see a crazy lady on the beach twisting like this, it's possibly me. It is just such a wonderful movement to do. Your feet don't have to be parallel. Let them turn out a little as your body twists from side to side, and even looking a little further behind you. And then you can let the arms be like limp spaghetti, just whacking against your body, and you get this little bit of a wake up here as well. And maybe letting the arms come up higher so they whack against the kidneys and the adrenals, which is going to, you know, we do naturally get a little bit of an adrenaline squirt when we wake up in the morning. It does wake us up. So whacking there, hopefully you're doing this practice in the morning. But just that little bit of a wake up, and even at the shoulders. So lifting the arms up and just whacking against the shoulders and the arms, and letting them come back down to just a natural place. And then you can stand still. So this is that principle of change your shape, change your state. So we've moved our body in a particular way. And for me, I can feel all this zinging and buzzing, and I feel so alive just from that one movement. Then adding in the beach and all the prana and negative ions from the ocean air, just love it. So I highly recommend that. I can definitely prescribe that. You can come to Tadasana at the front of the mat and inhale to sweep the arms up overhead. We'll take a little bit of a ladder flow. Exhale forward and down. Take an inhale to lift halfway up, and then planting the hands, step yourself back into downward facing dog, just warming our body a little. Inhale to stretch the right leg to the sky. And exhale, take a tiger curl rounding through the back. Inhale to stretch up. And exhale the foot forward to the hands, dropping the back knee down, and just one breath to inhale and lift, just exploring the movement so far. Inhale back into plank and exhale into your downward facing dog. Inhale and sending the left leg to the sky. And exhale into a tiger curl, rounding through the back. Inhale, send the leg up and back, and stepping forward. Take the back knee to the earth, and just one breath, lifting and straight back down. Inhale into your plank and exhale to downward facing dog. And then going again, inhale the right leg to the sky, into that tiger curl, rounding. So still the smooth, even movements. And the way that we move our body can soothe the nervous system as well. So straightening through the back leg this time, just one breath to lift, and exhaling back down. Inhale into your plank and exhale into downward facing. Inhale the left leg to the sky. And exhale, tiger curl. Inhale up and back. And then exhaling the foot forward. Inhale to sweep the arms up. and exhale to the earth. So in a moment, we're going to add in a more invigorating move. So from plank, you can lower yourself down onto the earth, rise up, inhaling to lift into your Shalabhasana, and then go ahead and take cobra or your Sphinx pose. Just a little back bend to open. And exhaling down. Tuck the toes, lift everything up. And exhaling back into downward facing dog. So same moves. Inhale the right leg to the sky. And then exhaling, tiger curl. Inhale up and back again. And then stepping forward, but perhaps not all the way forward, maybe just a shorter stance, and even having that back knee bent here. So inhaling to lift, and then exhale, you can just go hands onto the hips for a moment as we then lift the left knee up into the chest. So just getting the, like a dance class, getting the movements in the legs first and then stepping back. And we'll do this a few times. So using some, if you need a wall to balance, you could do that. And we'll just do this one more time. You can inhale the arms up overhead and exhale to the earth. Step back through your plank on an inhale and exhaling into downward facing dog. Then inhale the left leg to the sky. Tiger curl, rounding. Inhale up and back. And then stepping forward, but maybe not all the way. So you've got that shorter stance and even having the back knee bent. So as I often say, it's not going to make the cover of Yoga Journal looking like this, but functionally, it's great right now. All right, so then we'll stand down through the left leg and lift the right leg up. So you can inhale here and exhale to step back. And doing this a few times, just getting the move in your body, getting the used to the balance. So I do love HIIT, so it's the high intensity interval training. Just doing that for a little bit, you can come down. Inhale to take the arms up and exhaling the hands down to the earth. Step yourself back into plank and lowering down, maybe a chaturanga and up dog, or you can stick with your cobra, that's entirely up to you. And then exhaling to press back, downward facing dog. Excellent. All right, so we're going to pick up the pace with it, not do a HIIT training, but so take your right leg to the sky. Exhale a tiger curl. And then stretching the leg up and back. And stepping forward. So yogic inspired intensity. So you can here take the arms down, and as you come forward, like you would with walking, as you bring this left knee forward, you'll bring the right arm forward, and then picking up the pace a little if you can, and maybe dropping down lower. And if you want even more intensity, you could add in a hop. So just doing maybe 5 or 6 of these. And then coming back into your lunge. Awesome. Should feel the burn in that left glute, exhaling down. Inhale back into your plank and exhale back to downward facing. Then sending left leg to the sky and tiger curl. Inhaling up and back And stepping forward, again, maybe that shorter stance for you. Inhale the arms up. And then as you take the arms down, so just like you would with a walking gait, as this right knee comes forward, the left arm comes forward and switching. So doing it maybe a little faster, and it maybe doesn't happen with your breath so much. You might like to add in that little hop. Just a couple more. And then stepping back, inhale the arms up. Aren't you glad you got up this morning for a bit of yoga-ish stuff? And then step back into your plank. So plank pose, we're actually going to stay here and draw the right knee into the chest, step it back, left knee, step it back. So these are, in the fitness world, mountain climbers. And if you wanted to, you could pick up the pace with that as well. And then let's come and pause in child's pose, separating the knees out. You can circle through the wrists. Allow the breath to return to normal. Slowing the breath down. Feel the heart pumping, beating in the chest, sending the blood through the body. So as you move your body, we are stimulating all the systems. Stagnation is the enemy of the human body. Feel everything flowing within you. Blood, lymph, energy. And then from here, we'll come up through a hands and knees position. You can take the right knee behind you, bring the left knee over to the right side. We're coming into Gomukhasana, so sitting back onto the heels, sitting back to the inside of the heels. So if you can't manage this one, you could certainly just do legs crossed or even single leg pigeon. But from here, let's fold forward and stretch out those hips that we might have asked a bit of. So not here too long, just a couple of melting breaths. Perhaps releasing through the jaw. Again, that slowing the breath down. And then inhaling and coming on up. So we've got that left leg on top, whichever leg you've got on top, and we'll come into Ardha Matsyendrasana. So whether it's foot to the inside or the outside, twisting around to the left. So I'm not mirroring you here. You might like to go upper arm to the outside of the leg and twisting offers us another viewpoint. So just take that opportunity to see a different perspective. I know plenty of yoga teachers are purists and it has to be a particular way, but I drink from many streams and all those streams go into the one ocean anyway. And really, this is all about longevity and sustainability of the body. And for me, as I turn 50 this year in September, I am thinking a lot about longevity. I'm not even at the halfway mark, is the way I see it. All right, so turning forward and then crossing the legs over the other way for your Gomukhasana. Any variation of, or you could do simply pigeon pose with the other leg forward. And then folding, aware of the sensations that you're experiencing through the outer hip and tuning in, making sure that it is, we don't want pain. A sensation of stretch is fine, but applying some wisdom and discernment there. Listening to your inner teacher. So if you can, folding forward. If you're staying more vertical, that's fine too. Tune in to the breath. Tuning in also to the feeling that moving your body has created within you. So these endorphins, feel good hormones, are secreted. You should feel good, maybe not during, but after you move your body and after a little bit of intensity as well. Okay, let's come on up and rearrange the legs for this Ardha Matsyendrasana, maybe lifting up the right hip to turn it into the twist as you find again that new perspective, fresh awareness. And then you can inhale to turn and look forward, either taking a short shavasana, laying down, or maybe a seated shavasana. Again, this is really the difference between yoga and other forms of exercise, is this mini moment at the end just to take stock. How am I doing? How is my body feeling after a little bit of movement? Maybe you've got a sweat glow. Maybe there's this lightness inside or a brightness in your mind. Whatever it is, you can carry that with you through your day. Namaste, dear friends. Thank you so much for your presence and for your practice. And your body thanks you. Your body definitely thanks you. Blessings to you all.